Okay, the first thing to know about this video is if you're watching it on YouTube, that means that this work has worked. If I've ridden the bike for 3 or 6 months and there's no problems with the oil cooling or the hoses, then I'll put it on YouTube live. Any small problems that I've encountered, you'll see some annotations there explaining what to do or how to correct anything. Okay, so I've got my Harley oil cooler. It's an old oil cooler, second hand, and I just had to make the hole, I think, in the oil cooler a little bit bigger. I put a bolt through with a nut on the other side and I've tightened it up. So I've got 3 meters of 5/8 oil transmission hose. This is made in the USA. I'd suggest buying your oil cooler hose from Harley-Davidson. But as I say, if you're watching this video, then all this work has worked, and that's assuming this oil hose has worked as well. Made in the USA, so it should be of good quality. Okay, so we're looking at the oil pump right now, and there's 2 outlets on top of the oil pump. The one closest to the engine goes around and up to the oil cooler. This is the hose from the oil filter, and the oil filter goes to the other connection there, the outer connection. This is looking at the other connection or outlet from the oil cooler there, and that goes along and that connects to the oil filter. Okay, this is the oil line going to the oil cooler. This is the outlet, the oil pump outlet. It's got to be pushed on pretty tight, especially if you've got these clamps. Okay, I've decided to thread the pipe, oil pipe, along the big end area here and around the gearbox and to the oil filter.
Thank you. lastly, for the Socceroos, now I thought you didn't even know what the round ball code was.
The inner point or connection of the oil filter that goes up and around and enters the top of the oil bag or the oil container. Okay, so the outer connection of the oil pump there, what connects to that is the drain from the bottom of the oil holder, the oil can. That's the pipe there from the bottom of the oil can, and you can see here the pipe from the bottom of the oil can, and that connects to the outer connection of the oil pump. You can see this oil hose above the oil pump that just goes along and up to the top of the oil can. There's another oil hose, it's this one here, and that you can probably see it there, just there. That comes out of the engine, inside and below the oil pump there, and that just drains out into the atmosphere. This maybe it's not below, but it's certainly beside the inside of the oil pump here. Don't forget to put your oil back in your bag. Okay, I've just checked every single clamp with a good screwdriver like this, and I was able to get a lot more torque on all these clamps, because you don't want any of these clamps coming apart when you're riding. You'll lose your oil and you'll be stranded on the road. Okay, I'll just point out what an old worn oil hose looks like. You may be able to see that that's got very small cracks in it in this area here, and if you ever notice anything like that, you want to get onto it and replace that hose as soon as you can. Okay, so I'll just go through the work I've just done. I started from here, the inner point of the oil pump, and I've gone down. I haven't kinked it. I've kept a round circle for the flow of the oil through. I've decided to go underneath the frame, and I've connected it here, there, and it curls up around the frame. I've connected it there with a tie, a third plastic tie, and then at the oil cooler, I've connected it with a clamp. That's a Harley-Davidson oil cooler for bikes up to about 84. This is a 1984 FXWG wide glide. I've connected it with a bolt on the frame where the horn was. I've put the horn at the side here. Then at the exit from the oil cooler, I've got a clamp. I've got a plastic tie there. It runs along the top of the big end and around the upright in the frame. Then here you can see on the other side of the upright, and then I've gone underneath the hoses to keep it down and away from the exhaust pipe, and then it goes around and on top of the gearbox. That's the clutch gear stick. It's clear of that, it's underneath that. This is on the other side here. There's a primary drive, the belt drive, there's a belt drive cover, and the pipe sits on top of the primary drive cover, or on top of the other oil hose. And I've got it clamped there on the oil hose, got it clamped to the oil filter, and you can see there that it runs along and underneath and clear of the clutch gear stick there, or the clutch cam system. I tried to bring the hose along the front of the engine for simplicity and not to get into the way of any operating levers or anything like that to wear the hose out, but it all seemed safe behind the going around the gearbox. But I found that I couldn't bring it across here because there wasn't any fixing point. So I found that was the safest way. Probably plenty of guys don't agree with that method. That's your right. But however, as I say, if this video is posted live on YouTube, then this has all worked. When I was looking at the right technique to install an oil cooler on a 1984 Harley shovel, there was almost no information. Now, if you type in SCHEMATIC, a 1983 Harley FXR shovel head with an oil cooler hooked up, you'll find on an Apple, you'll find this the same. So I click on that and I'll find a diagram here on this web page of the oil pump on a shovel and what all the outlets are and inlets. This is justanswer.com. This information is from Bill, and it says here, experience of Bill, over 35 years working for large Harley-Davidson, Honda, KTM, multi-line dealer. And this guy, Bill, deserves a medal. Okay, just bear with me while I read this out. If you still want to hang around for this, might be good information. I'm just going to read out what Bill says here, what Bill's written, and explain the outlets he's referring to. So this picture should help, this picture here, he says. The return line from the oil pump goes to the oil cooler. So the return, which is that one there, goes to the oil cooler. Then to the filter at the rear of the transmission case. Then to the oil tank. So he's referring to the innermost connection there. He goes on to say, there are three lines on the oil tank. The bottom one is the feed, and there's the connection for the feed. The next one up is the vent, then the return line. If you're not sure, just put a small amount of oil in the tank. The feed line will have oil coming out first. There's the feed. So I'll try and make this as compressed as possible, not to bore you. That's the vent there. He says vent to top of the oil tank. He says it could have a T inline that connects to and also vents the primary chain housing. He says that's the return. So it says here, return to top of the oil tank. Put oil filter and oil cooler in line with this one. He says the outer one here, he says feed, gravity feed, from the bottom of the oil tank. This is the oil supply for the engine and possibly the primary chain. Seems to be a little nib here. He says primary chain oiler plugged off in this example. He's got this outlet here. He's got rear chain oiler route to rear chain, rate adjustable with slotted screw. He's got down underneath, he's got this plugged off area here, and he's got primary oil return. There is another 1/8 pipe fitting back in here on the crankcase that would be used to suck the oil back from the primary chain housing, plugged off in this example. Next one, he's referring to this outlet pointing down. He says crankcase vent. This one is simply routed to the atmosphere. Just run it somewhere under the bike. A good touch would be to let it blow on the rear chain. You could see this one routed to the air cleaner.